Okay, so in this video we're going to be taking a look at the Sonic Modell AR Wing. As you can see, I already have everything unpacked and laid out here on my workbench, which is a little bit messy otherwise, so I do apologize for that. And I also apologize, you can probably hear my electric heater running in the background, but it is rather cold out right now, so I kind of need the heater to be in here doing this, so we'll just have to make the best of it. Getting into the airplane, this is all the parts that were included. These little camera mount pieces here. This is for like a GoPro style and a GoPro session style here. These were not assembled. I did have to assemble these myself and glue them. I've seen pictures of the airplane where these were actually shipped assembled. Mine were not, so your mileage may vary on that. Other than that, this is how everything came out of the box. There was absolutely no damage. Everything was packed quite well inside the box. We can take a look at that, actually. If you notice, inside the box, everything is packed away into individual smaller boxes, which inside each individual small box was plenty of foam and bubble wrap and packing material and things like that. And as is typical fashion with Gearbest, this was all double packed inside of an even second larger box. So good job Gearbest on the shipping and packaging. It arrived fast with, like I said, zero damage to the box itself or anything inside. So that was really nice to see. And while I do have the box open, take a look at this instruction sheet, which, if you can call it that, it's basically just kind of an exploded diagram of all the parts and how everything fits together on one side, and then the other side just kind of explains where your CG is at and pre-molded slide inside here for servo wire route. The servos are already mounted, wires are routed, so it's not a big deal. But anyway, that's all you get as far as instructions. And one last thing in the box is the decal sheet. And this is the little stripes and checker pattern and Sonic Modell logo that's in all of the finished pictures of the model. I may or may not mount those later. But anyway, we'll set all this aside and get it out of the way and take a look at the actual model itself. First things first, we'll look at the center section, or I guess you could call it the fuselage. Like I said, you do get some camera mounts which would fit right up in the front here. You have this little plywood tray right in here set up to hold your battery. Comes with a Velcro strap already in place. Some Velcro stuck to the floor of that tray. Your ESC and motor is already mounted. Comes with an XT60 connector. This is the same little fly color fairy 30 amp ESC, which has a 1 amp BEC. Marginal at best, there's no break in this. This is the same speed controller that comes in the Nano Talon, which brings up a point. The Nano Talon is a ZOHD, Z-O-H-D, branded product, which is actually a sub-brand, I guess you want to call it, a smaller division of Sonic Modell, which makes this airplane. So my guess is that they actually come out of the same factory. The motor on this one is mounted to a little plywood firewall in the back, and it is a 2204 2300 kV motor with no branding on it, just a standard little mini quad type motor. It's 2204 2300 kV. It's what a lot of mini quads started on. These are kind of outdated as far as mini quads go by now. In my opinion, I think it may be a little bit small for a wing of this size, but we will fly it and find out, because I know a lot of people are flying them on the stock setup and having good results. On the bottom, you have a couple of little landing skegs, whatever. Kind of makes for a nice little handle if you want to launch it that way, which you may need to be mindful of your prop, which I guess we'll get into that stuff later. On the topic of the camera mounts, like I said, this one is set up for a session style camera, and this one would be set up for a GoPro style, and I believe this is also applicable to something like a Mobius type of camera. and those will actually fit into the front section of the airplane, like so. And then you have these snap-on foam covers, which are mounted with magnets. You have some magnets mounted on the front of the foam there, some glued into the back of the foam here, and that cover just snaps in place like that over your camera. And if you're using the other style of camera, you would mount it right in here. And once again, you have a nice little cover there with a little hole for your lens to poke through. Now, I believe there should have been a third nose piece, foam cover, whatever you want to call it, like these. I think there should have been a third one in the box with a round hole centered in the front. But my package did not include it, but I have seen it in the product photos as well as some of the other reviews. So maybe it was just left out of my box. I'm not sure. No big deal. I will more than likely run the RunCam 3 in this mount here with this cover. And if not the RunCam 3, then it would definitely be a GoPro style camera, which I would use with the other combination here. So that's not an issue. Setting these aside, this is your fuselage cover, or hatch rather, for the center section of the plane. Kind of keys into the back there with this tab. And you have a couple of magnets which will interact with these magnets here on the front to get that mounted up. You have a little tab to make it easier to remove it. And an air intake and a couple of air exits for cooling. Cover fits like so. And once again, you have really positive engagement with those magnets. Really quick and easy. Go ahead and put a camera mount setup in place. Just to show you how everything works together. And you see, once the camera mount's in place, you can still install the hatch. And with the hatch in place, you can install or remove that cover. They don't, you know, interfere with each other. But that's how the finished fuselage looks, with the hatches and covers and everything in place. Nice and clean setup. The wing halves come with the servos pre-installed, linkage is set up. Basic little Z-band on here, a threaded plastic clevis on this end. You do have a foam hinge on the control surface, and the control horn does have a backing plate on the bottom side there, and two screws which mount it together so it sandwiches in that foam for a really positive install. There's zero slop in the linkages there. I like that. They're nice and tight. Not sure how strong these little rods are, but for a basic medium performance beginner wing, which this is geared to be, especially with the power setup that comes on it, this is more than adequate, I believe. If you end up upgrading your power system, you may want to strengthen these control rods a little bit, maybe replace these clevises, but that'll be up to you. I mean, you know, if you want to start modifying things, that's up to you. But you have these little plywood plates here with a couple of threaded holes, which will be to install your winglets, which also have a little plate. And if you notice, there's kind of a little recess molded into the foam, and that keys into the tip of the wing there. They actually lock together like so, and they fit quite well, as you can see. Actually go into place without the screws, but for, you know, for a more permanent install, you put the two screws in place and hold those on. On the underside of the wing here, you can see this little pocket is already glued in place, which that's where your servo wires are in. And you see this little square hole here. It's for a carbon spar, which is included. You do have another carbon rod already glued in place along the leading edge of the wing here. And you have one in the bottom of the control surface, the elevon there, to stiffen it. Really nice, rigid, good install, you know, good build, good quality. At the root here, you have this plywood plate with a threaded metal insert, which is for these thumb screws here, which screw into that threaded metal insert like so. And that is for mounting the wing halves to the fuselage center section. Let's see, the only other thing, you had these four little threaded screws here, which are for holding the winglets on. You have a prop, which is a 6x3 standard direction. It's a tractor prop, so you'll have to mount it with the lettering, curved surfaces, and lettering forward, and we'll actually have to run the motor in reverse to get a pusher configuration out of a tractor prop, which is handy because that kind of opens up your options as far as prop goes. You can run mini quad props, as well as if you want to go with the older, the standard like APC airplane props. Those are readily available in tractor configuration, which you can get them in pusher also, but it's easier to find the tractor configuration, especially at some of your local hobby shops, things of that nature. The prop is not super rigid, it's somewhat flexible, kind of average, I would guess. I guess we'll probably find out how durable that prop is, because like I said, there is no brake on the included ESC. So once you mount that prop up on your motor, it's definitely going to hang down below the fuselage, so it may get snagged up on landing. Well, I mean, it's pretty much guaranteed it's going to snag in the grass on landing. And we'll see how long that lasts before we have to end up replacing the prop, and likely replacing the ESC to put one with a brake in it, because I just prefer having a brake. And if I leave this ESC in place, I will definitely be running an external BEC when I get around to putting some FPV gear in it, because I don't trust the one-out BEC, especially on such a small speed controller. As like I said, this is basically a repurposed mini quad ESC. You know, it's your typical small little ESC that you would find on a mini quad. The only other thing I haven't looked at yet, I kind of overlooked, is you do have a little kind of double-sided, little double-ended Velcro strap, which is used in conjunction with your camera mounts in the front to hold your camera into the plywood mounts. And your carbon spar, which is included. It is an extruded, square, hollow carbon rod, which will slide into the wing halves and through the fuselage like so. And you do have these little plywood doublers where it goes through on both sides for added strength. And you see these little holes in the back of the wing root section here is where your servo cables are going to pass through. This little hole in the center of each one is where the threaded thumb screw will come through. And that tightens against this plywood backing here, so it kind of sandwiches all this foam, spreads the load out, which is nice. See, on this half, you do have another little square hole here, which is for passing through your camera wires for your FPV camera. You do have this little molded pocket for holding an FPV camera, and you see you'll route your cables out through that slot right in here, which will correspond to that little square hole there and allow you to get your camera cables back into the fuselage. So let's go ahead and assemble one half. You'll route that servo cable through, and you want to make sure you get your spar keyed in like so. I hope you're able to see what I'm doing here. Basically, I have the spar started in a square hole. Your servo cable is going to be routed through that hole into the center of the fuselage, where you can catch it right under here like so. And you'll just slide it in, making sure you don't pinch your servo cable in the process. Slide that in, make sure your spar is mounted all the way into your wing. And you'll take one of your threaded thumb screws and put it in the center hole in the plywood plate there. And thread it right in like so. And just run that up nice and snug, and that half is mounted. And you'll repeat the process for your other wing. And get it in place, get the cable, servo cable, started and ran through in place, pull the slack out. And now we want to screw in the other screw, obviously. So your wing halves are mounted to your center section, nice and strong, nice and solid. You do have a bit of free play side to side in your spar. See, we grab it right in the center, we can slide it over that far before it butts from one wing to the other. So if you're a perfectionist, you may want to center that up. Just kind of take the slack out. I mean, it's totally up to you. I'm sure it's going to be fine either way, but I probably would go ahead and mark the center of the spar and align it in the center of the fuselage, just because I can. Why not? But we'll go ahead and pop the cover on. See a nice, sleek, smooth surface there. So move your extra camera mount out of the way. We'll go ahead and mount up one of your wing tips really fast. Actually going to mount it like this so I can see what I'm doing. Go ahead and snug up both screws in here. So that one's done. It's mounted very solidly. It's not going anywhere. Nice and clean, smooth finish. So we'll repeat the process on the other side. Make sure we get that lined up properly. And once again, we just want to snug those screws up in place. So that's your finished wing as far as the build. One thing left to do is to mount the prop, which we can probably go ahead and do really fast. The nut that's included is a self-locking nut. I really like to see that, especially on a pusher setup, because this is not a reverse thread, so you almost need, you almost require a locking nut to make sure it doesn't loosen itself up in flight. Go ahead and grab a wrench, snug this up. It's the first time you run one of these locking nuts up over the threads, it is kind of a snug fit, but once you run it on and off a couple of times, it will loosen up a little bit. So that's it, prop mounted. The entire build, unless you want to mount the, put the included decals in place. But as far as assembling the airframe itself, that's all there is to it. Like I said, on the underside of the wing, you do have these little landing skids here, and it will also land on the wing tips. So actually, all things considered, it's going to sit from here to here. Your prop is going to hang maybe about an inch or so below the actual hard points on the fuselage. But it will snag in the grass, but I don't expect to break a prop on landing. But if we do, like I said, it's a 6x3 prop. Standard size shaft. It's not a self-tightening one like the nanotalon, anything like that. So props should be readily available. I already have tons of spares. Different sizes, whatever. I could experiment with different size props if I wanted to. But for now, we're going to run it on the stock setup. I will be putting FPV gear in this. Obviously, that's what it's designed for. I will be running the RunCam 3, and I believe I'm going to run a RunCam Owl Plus 2, which I have sitting right over here, by the way. It's the RunCam Owl Plus 2. You probably can't read that, but take my word for it. And so I've already mounted the flat back plate on the Owl Plus 2 because they come with optional plate with these standoffs here, which I've swapped out for the flat back plate, so it will drop right into place in the pocket like so, and it's a snug fit. I don't even think you're going to need any glue or anything like that to hold it. It fits snugly right in place. It's molded perfectly for it. And you can see you have just enough room to run your cable out from the connector, from the camera connector. You can see how snug it is there. I'm trying to pull it out. It's kind of a tight fit. But you see your connector here. This one you have power ground video, audio, and VBAT, because it does have an OSD in this camera, which your voltage and timer, which is going to be handy flying it on just a basic stock FPV setup without an autopilot or flight control or anything like that, or other external OSD for that matter. I'm going to be using the internal OSD in the camera, and your OSD connector for the camera is not accessible once it's in place. You shouldn't need to access it very often. If you do, you'll just have to pop the camera up slightly, or you can plug into it and then just slide it back in place when you're done. But it's a nice tight snug fit. It's not going anywhere. Black matches a black wing, so you'll have an FPV camera sitting out here and your HD camera sitting in here recording. But anyway, that's about all I can show you now. I'm kind of getting to the point where I'm rambling on talking about stuff that's probably boring you now. So I'm probably going to put this video out now. My next video, I will have a basic FPV setup with my RC receiver installed and set up and ready to fly it. I probably won't even bother with line of sight flying because it is an FPV wing. That's what it's made for. That's what it's going to do best. It's what you're going to be buying it for, anyone who decides to buy one. So we'll jump right into an FPV flight next. Should happen less than a week if the weather plays out like it's supposed to, according to the forecast. But so just keep an eye out for that, and I will get that done as soon as possible. I want to thank Gearbest for sending me this wing. I will have some affiliate links to it below. Like I said, they are affiliate links. If you want to click them, I'm not telling you. You have to go out and buy this. If you're going to buy it, I would appreciate you using the link. It'll help me out. If not, that's fine. If you want to purchase it and you don't want an affiliate link, just go type in gearbest.com and search for AR Wing. It should come up. Or any other reseller, I guess. But like I said, Gearbest did provide me this one for review, so thank you, Gearbest. I have to support them for that decision. And like I said, this is available a few dollars cheaper at other retailers, but like I said, I really found Gearbest shipping and packing to be higher standard than usual, above average, I guess you could say. I was really impressed with that. It's the first time I've actually received a package from China that arrived in about 4 days, if I remember right, and it was packaged very well with zero damage to the insides or the outsides of the package. So thumbs up to Gearbest for that, and thank you for watching this video. Subscribe so that you can see the next one if you're not already subscribed to my channel. And I've rambled on long enough, so I'm going to end this video here. Thank you and goodbye. See you in the next one.